Hello everyone, welcome to my presentation. I am dealing with the subject power plant engineering. In that topic is steam power plant. The outline of my presentation is combustion classifications, in that speeder stroker, under speeder strokers. In that first one is speeder stroker. Speeder stroker mechanism involves throwing or spreading the coal uniformly on the grate. The grate may be of stationary or moving type with an air opening for admitting the air. The selection of coal size is very important for a speeder stroker. The coal size is in between 6 cm to 36 cm. The speeder stroker is mostly used for steam capacity of 9.5 to 50 kg per second, that is 34 to 180 tons per hour. It can be burn a wide variety of coals from high ranking, that is from bituminous to lignite. Since fuel is not used, it is used for the domestic purpose only. It is not used for the generation of electricity. This is the basic diagram of the speeder stroker. In this type of stroker, the coal is not fed into the furnace by means of a grater. The function of a grater is only to support a bed of ash and move it to the furnace. From the chop coal hoppers, the coal is fed in the path of the rotor by means of a conveyor and it is thrown into the furnace by the rotor and it is burned in a suspension. The air of combustion is supplied into the hole of the grate. This is the air supplied. The secondary air is supplied through the hole of the grate. The secondary air to create turbulence and supply oxygen for through combustion of coal is supplied to the nozzle directly into the ignition. Unburned coal and ash are deposited on the grate and it is moved periodically, which can be used for the furnace. Speeder stroker can be burned any type of the coal. This type of the coal can be used for the boilers, ranges capacities from 70,000 kg to 140,000 kg of steam per hour. The heat releases rate of 10 into 10 to the power of 6 kilocalorie per meter square hour is used. The speed of the stroker is 15 to 50 centimeter per minute. The coal bed thickness is shown for all times by an index plate. This can be regulated either by adjusting the opening of the fuel grate or by speed control of the stroker driving motor. The air is admitted from the underside of the grate, which is divided into several compartments, each connected to an air duct. The grate must be saved from being overheated. For this, coal should have sufficient ash content, which will form a layer on the grate. Since there is periodically no ignition of the fuel bed, no cracking coals are best suitable for the grater coals. The rate of the burning with the stroker is 200 to 300 kg per meter square hour when the force draught is used. So when the coal is entered to the gas hopper through the feeder and the speeder is used for the air and the additional air is supplied here and the refuse coal and the pit is collected here and the secondary air duct is entered here for the complete combustion of the coal. This is the block diagram. The advantages: a wide variety of the coal can be burned. The clinker problems can be reduced by spreading action. High temperature preheated air can be used. High temperature preheated air can be used. Volatile matter is removed by burning coal in suspension. Good response of load fluctuations. Low running cost. Fire actors, etc. are generally not required with this type of stokers. Volatile matter is very easily burned. Operation cost is very low. The use of the high temperature preheated is very possible. And coming to disadvantages, difficult to operate with varying sizes of coal with varying moisture content. Fly ash is a major problem. Fuel loss due to the suspension and exhaust gases. So these are the basic principle, advantages and disadvantages of speeder stroker. There is a possibility of some of the fuel loss in the clinkers upon the stroke because of the thin fuel bed and suspension burning. And underfeed mechanism. This underfeed mechanism is best suited for bituminous and semi-bituminous coal. In this underfeed mechanism, the fuel is fed from under the fire and moves upward gradually. The air entering through the grate openings come in contact with the raw fuel and mixes with the volatile matter, releases from the raw fuel and enters into the combustion chamber. The basic principle of the underfeed stroker. This is a block diagram for the underfeed stroker. If we see this, the air entering through the holes of the grater comes in contact with the raw coal and it is passes through the indecent coal where the reaction similar to the overfeed system. The gases produced may pass through the layer, secondary air supplied to the burn the combustion. Means, if we see this, primary air and primary air with water is supplied here. The combustion takes place in between the indecent coal and the green coal. So, here the combustion takes place. And the volatile matter plus carbon dioxide and carbon monoxide, nitrogen and oxygen reacts here, that is combustion takes place. When the coal is get complete combustion, some of the ash is formed. When the ash is completely heated, some of the flames are formed. And here in the flames, carbon dioxide, oxygen, hydrogen and water is there in the flame. And if we supply the secondary air, the complete combustion takes place and the in between the indecent coal and the green coal. So these types are used for the complete combustions. So this is the basic principle. Here the volatile matter gets converted into the water. That is, when we heated the water, steam is converted. And the classifications of underfeed strokers. So, underfeed strokers are broadly classified into two types. Single retort stroker and multi retort stroker. Single retort stroker. The single retort stroker consists of a trough shaped retort to which the fuel is fed by a reciprocating ramp or screw conveyor. The capacity of this stroker ranges from 100 to 2000 kg of coal burned per hour. And second one is the multi-retort stroker. The coal falling from the hopper is pushed forward during the inward stroke of the stroker. The distribution ramps then slowly moves the entire coal bed down the length of the stroker. The slope of the stroker helps in moving the fuel bed downwards. The primary air enters the fuel bed from the main window box suited below the stroker. Partial burnt coal moves onto the extension grate. The air entering from the main window box into the extension grate. Window box is graduated by the air damper. and the advantages of single rotor stroker is given below. A wide variety of coal can be burned. Operation coal is very low. So these are the advantages. And coming to multi-rotor feed stroker. The stroker consists of a series of sloping parallel troughs. So these are the sloping parallel troughs. Under the coal hopper, at the end of the retorts, feeding rams with reciprocating blocks and fur, with the ram on the upper outer portion of the coal from the hopper falls into the space vacated by the rail. On the upward stroke, the ram forces the coal into the retort. The height and the profile of the fuel bed is controlled by the secondary distribution rams. These rams associated parallel to the retort axis, the length of these strokes can be varied as needed. They slowly move into the entire fuel bed down the length of the stroker. As the rear of the stroker, the partially burned fuel bed moves into the extension grate arranged in the sections. In these sections also associates with the parallel into the fuel bed movement. The sharp slope of the strokes aid in moving the fuel bed. The fuel bed movement keeps it slightly ignition to break up clinker formation. From the extension grate, the ash moves up onto the ash dump plate. Tilting the dump plate at long interval deposits the ash in the ash pit below. Primary air from the wind box underneath the stroker enters the fuel bed through the holes in the vertical slides of the dryers. The extension grate carries a much thinner fuel bed so that to have a lower air pressure under it. The air entering from the main window box, the air is entered into the main window box where the extension grate wind box is regulated by controlling the air damper. So this is the air damper, this is the window box. Underfeed strokers are suitable for non-clinkering, high volatile coals, having cracking properties and low ash contents. Advantages are higher thermal efficiency. Combustion rate is way higher thermal efficiency when compared to chain grate stroker. The grater is self-cleaning. Combustion rate is considerably high. Part load efficiency is high with multiple retort system. Wide varieties of coal is used. Much higher streamer ratings are possible with this type of strokes. Greater bores, troughs and retorts are not subjected to higher temperature as they always remain in contact with the fresh fuel, that is coal. Overload capacity of the boiler is high as the large amount of coal is carried on the grate. Smokeless operation is possible even at very high load. With the use of clinker graders, more heat can be liberated out of the fuel. It can be used with all refractory furnaces because of non-expensive of the stroker mechanism in the furnace. And coming to disadvantages, the initial cost is very high, large building areas is required, clinker troubles are usually present, low-grade coals with high ash content can be burned economically. So in this lecture, we discussed about the spreader stroker and underfeed strokers. In underfeed strokers, there are two types, single and multi-rotor stroker, are explained in this lecture. In my next lecture, we'll discuss about the combustion chambers.